children, today we will start up with the third lesson 1.3 on Wings of Courage. In this lesson, we are going to read about an Air Force Marshal, Arjun Singh, his achievements, his contribution, and the notable work that he has done for the Indian Air Force, and how he reached to the pinnacle of success. That is what we are going to read in this lesson. So we'll start the lesson now. Air Force Marshal Arjun Singh, an icon of India's military history, will always be remembered as a war hero who had successfully led a young IAF during the 1965 Indo-Pak War. So the Air Force Marshal, his name is Arjun Singh, he is said to be an icon. Icon you can write as symbol of pride. He is a symbol of pride for India's military history. We always remember him as a war hero. Which war hero? The Indo-Pak War in 1965. He was successful in winning over the Pakistani Air Force because he led our young IAF, that is Indian Air Force, successfully against Pakistan. The only officer to attain the highest post of Marshal, the Air Force equivalent to Army's 5-star Field Marshal. So he is the first and the only one to get this highest post of Marshal. And this post that he gets, this post is equal to another post. Which post? To the Army's 5-star Field Marshal. That means Air Force Marshal ka jo post inko mila, ye itna high post hai, aur ye post kiske equivalent hai? Army ke 5-star Field Marshal ke post ke ekdam equal hai. Now we have few lines for him. Singh was a fearless and exceptional pilot. Fearless, jinko dar nahi lagta hai. Exceptional means unusually good. So he was fearless. He was exceptional pilot who had flown more than 60 different types of aircraft. So in his lifetime, he has flown 60 types of aircraft. These are the pictures of Indo-Pak War children. And this is the award, the honor one gets as a field marshal and as Air Force Marshal. These are the types of aircrafts. He played a major role in transforming the IAF into one of the most potent air forces globally and the fourth biggest in the world. So he has played a major role, means a very important role in what? In transforming. Transforming means changing. तो उन्होंने बहुत बड़ा चेंज किया था किसमें इंडियन एयर फोर्स में वॉट एवर चेंजेस ही मेड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट आर आईएएफ बिकेम वेरी पोटेंट द मीनिंग फॉर पोटेंट इज ऑलरेडी गिवन इन द बुक चिल्ड्रन पावरफुल एंड इफेक्टिव सो ग्लोबली वी बिकेम अ पोटेंट एयर फोर्स एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द पावर दैट वी हैड इन आर इंडियन एयर फोर्स We came at the position of fourth biggest in the world. Now you can see the lines, they are written in inverted commas. So it means that these lines are spoken by someone. See the last line there. It is spoken by former vice chief of IAF Kapil Kak. Kapil Kak, ye us samay ke vice chief hua karte the Indian Air Force ke. Inhone dekhte hai ki kya kaha about Arjun Singh. His contribution to the Indian Air Force is monumental to the least. Monumental means of great importance. So he says, whatever he has done, it is really of great importance. The IAF grew with him. It so happened when he joined IAF, he was very young. Aur hamara IAF bhi tabhi form hua hi tha. So IAF and he both were so young and they grew together. He was the epitome of military leadership in classical sense. And it is therefore not surprising that he was honored with the rank of Air Force Marshal. So he says that he was an epitome. Again, epitome meaning is given in the book, children. Epitome means a perfect example. So he is said to be a perfect example of military leadership. जो उनमें qualities होने चाहिए एक leadership, military leadership के सब थे उनमें. इसीलिए काक कहते हैं कि it was not a surprise when he was honored with the rank of Air Force Marshal. He deserved it actually. Singh was honored with the rank of Marshal on the Republic Day in 2002. Sam Hermansji, Framji Jamshedji, Manekshaw and K.M. Karyappa were the only two army generals honored with the rank of field marshal. तो जिस पोस्ट के बारे में, जिस ऑनर के बारे में हम बात कर रहे हैं, एयरफोर्स मार्शल, तो ये रैंक उनको कब मिला उसके बारे में लिखा है. दिस रैंक अर्जन सिंह गॉट ऑन द रिपब्लिक डे, दैट इज़ 26 जनवरी इन द ईयर 2002. बिफोर हिम ओनली टू पीपल वर देयर ऑन दिस पोस्ट, बट देवर इन द फील्ड मार्शल, दैट इज़ इन द आर्मी कैटेगरी. द टू पीपल वर सैम हरमसजी फ्रामजी जमशेदजी मानेकशॉ and the other person was K.M. Karyappa. Known as a man of few words, Singh was not only a fearless pilot but also had profound knowledge about air power and applied it in a wide spectrum of areas. Man of few words means bahut kam bolte the wo, and he was fearless pilot, ye pehle bhi hum padh chuke hain. Profound means immense, bahut jyada knowledge tha unke paas air power ke bare mein. ऑब्वियस है कि जो एयरक्राफ्ट उड़ाता है, दे हैव टू हैव गुड नॉलेज अबाउट द एयर पावर. सो ही हैड अ ग्रेट नॉलेज अबाउट एयर पावर. और सिर्फ इतना ही नहीं, वो उसको हमेशा अप्लाई भी करते थे. जो नॉलेज था वो उसको अप्लाई भी करते थे इन अ वाइड स्पेक्ट्रम, मीन्स इन वराइटी ऑफ वेज, एज पर द नीड ही केप्ट ऑन अप्लाइंग दिस एयर पावर. सिंह हैड एसिडसली लेड द IAF ड्यूरिंग द 1965 वॉर and denied success to Pakistani Air Force, though it was better equipped with American support. So once again we have a line about Indo-Pak War. Assiduously, the meaning is to work hard and showing careful attention to all the details. So when he was getting ready for the Indo-Pak War in 1965, he was working assiduously, means very hard he was working. उन्होंने हर एक डिटेल्स पे काम किया, हार्ड वर्क, और हर एक डिटेल्स को ध्यान से देखते परखते हुए उसके बाद उन्होंने बहुत अच्छे प्लानिंग्स और स्ट्रैटेजीज बनाए. स्ट्रैटेजीज इतने स्ट्रांग थे दैट वी वर सक्सेसफुल इन द इंडो पाक वॉर एंड पाकिस्तान लॉस्ट द वॉर. जबकि पाकिस्तानी एयरफोर्स वॉज स्ट्रॉन्गर देन इंडिया. Why the Pakistani Air Force was stronger than India? Because this Air Force of Pakistan was supported by America. Full support tha America ka, lekin tab bhi humne Pakistan ko haraya. So Kak says again, his most outstanding contribution was during that war. Kak ka yehi kehna hai ki us war ka jo unka contribution tha, wo sabse outstanding hai, the best contribution for the country. Commending his role in the war, YB Chauhan, the then defense minister, had written, Air Marshal Arjan Singh is a jewel of a person, quite efficient and firm, unexcitable but a very able leader. Commending the meaning is officially praising, kisi ki tarif karna. So these lines are said by YB Chauhan. Ye us samay ke defense minister the, aur Arjan Singh ke liye unhone kaha, that Air Marshal Arjan Singh is a jewel of a person. Jewel means very kind, very noble, as precious as jewel. Very efficient means he does all his work efficiently without any mistake. Firm, very strong. Unexcitable means he is always very cool and calm. Jyada excited hote nahi the wo. And obviously, he had all the ability to become a great leader. In 1944, the Marshal had led a squadron against the Japanese during the Arakan campaign, flying close air support missions during the crucial Imphal campaign, and later assisted the advance of the Allied forces to Yangon, formerly Rangoon. Okay children, थोड़ा इसके बारे में पहले समझते हैं. ये जो कैंपेन था, बेसिकली एक कैंपेन था अगेंस्ट, ये दोनों ही कैंपेन जापनीज के अगेंस्ट था. लेकिन पहला जो अरेकन कैंपेन था वो कंट्री था बर्मा, और बर्मा में एक सिटी हुआ करता था रंगून. अभी दोनों के ही नेम चेंज हो गए हैं. नाउ बर्मा हैज़ बिकम म्यांमार एंड रंगून हैज़ बिकम यांगून. ये तो हुआ यांगून, दैट इज़ अरेकन कैंपेन. दूसरा इम्फाल कैंपेन भी लिखा है. इम्फाल इज़ अ प्लेस इन इंडिया, एंड चाहे तुम अरेकन ले लो या इम्फाल ले लो, बोथ द प्लेसेस वर रूल्ड बाय द अलाइड फोर्सेस. अलाइड फोर्सेस हियर मींस द ब्रिटिशर्स स्पेशली. तो ब्रिटिशर्स का दोनों पे होल्ड था, बट जैपनीज दे वॉन्टेड टू कैप्चर अरेकन ऑल्सो, दे वॉन्टेड टू कैप्चर इम्फाल ऑल्सो, दे वॉन्टेड टू डिस्ट्रॉय द ब्रिटिशर्स देयर. तो जापनीज ने दोनों ही प्लेस पे अटैक किया था, अरेकन पे भी और इम्फाल पे भी. दैट टाइम वी वर अंडर द ब्रिटिश रूल, इसीलिए हमको उनकी तो सुननी ही थी. सो एज पर द कमांड फ्रॉम द ब्रिटिशर्स इन 1944, अर्जन सिंह लेड अ स्क्वाड्रन. स्क्वाड्रन मीन्स अ ग्रुप ऑफ एयरफोर्स ऑफिसर्स विथ एयरक्राफ्ट. सो ही लेड अ स्क्वाड्रन अगेंस्ट द जापनीज. That was an Arakan campaign, and the second one was Imphal campaign. That was again against the Japanese, and in both the campaigns, Marshall was a winner. He was very successful, and after this, he again assisted. Assisted means helped. He helped the Allied forces to advance. Means to move ahead. After this campaign, he helped the Allied forces to move ahead towards Yangon. In this map, you can see the Arakan and the Imphal campaign, children. In recognition of his feat, he was awarded the Distinguished Flying Cross. On the spot by the Supreme Allied Commander of Southeast Asia, the first Indian pilot to have received it. So just now I gave you the example, children, of Arakan campaign and also the Imphal campaign. In these two campaign, Arjan Singh was successful. That is why the Allied forces were very happy with him. So Allied forces ke jo supreme commander the, Southeast Asia ke Allied forces ke jo supreme commander the, he was so impressed that on the spot, usi samay, he gave Arjan Singh this award, Distinguished Flying Cross. And he is the first pilot who received this. Singh was selected for the Empire Pilot Training Course at Royal Air Force, RAF Cranville, in 1938. When he was 19 years old, he retired from service in 1969. So, little bit about his career has been given here. He was selected for the further training course in pilot, and he was asked to join Royal Air Force Cranville. Cranville is located in England. So for Empire Pilot Training Course, he went to Royal Air Force Cranville. That was in the year 1938. Bahut young the, only 19 years old. And he served India well and retired in the year 1969. Singh was born on April 15, 1919 in Lialpur, now Faisalabad, Pakistan, and completed his education on Montgomery, now Sahiwal, Pakistan. So, he was born in Pakistan. That time obviously it was India only, but then now the part where he was born is in Pakistan. So, he was born on April 15, 1919. Lialpur. Now the name has been changed and Lialpur ka naya name hai Faisalabad, Pakistan. Same thing, he got his education at Montgomery. Montgomery bhi old name hai aur new name hai Sahiwal, Pakistan. His first assignment on being commissioned was to fly Westland Wapiti biplanes in the northwestern frontier province as a member of the number 1 RIAF squadron. So, as the member of number 1 RIAF squadron, unko jo pehla assignment mila tha. In that first assignment, he was asked to fly Westland Wapiti biplanes. They are sort of planes, and I have put the picture in the next slide, so you can see there. After a brief stint with the newly formed number 2 RIAF squadron, where the Marshal flew against the tribal forces, he later moved to number 1 squadron as a flying officer to fly the Hawker Hurricane. So, a brief stint, the meaning is given to run a short period of work. So, actually he was the member of number 1 RIAF, but उसी समय number 2 RIAF भी बना, and Marshall ने number 2 RIAF कुछ समय के लिए join किया, specially उनको एक mission पे भेजा गया था against the tribal forces. So after completing the mission against the tribal forces, he again came back to number 1 squadron as a flying officer, and he flew Hawker Hurricane. It's also a fighter plane. He was promoted to the rank of squadron leader in 1944. So from here we are going to read about his promotions. Unka contribution itna strong raha hai ki uske baad unko promotions milte hi chale gaye. There was no stopping. So from here the promotions will come. For his role in successfully leading the squadron in combat, he was awarded the Distinguished Flying Cross DFC in 1944. It's the same line that is repeated here, children. Just now we had just finished off with that. That when he went for the 2 campaigns successfully, after that he was awarded with DFC. On August 15, 1947, he achieved the unique honor of leading a flypast of over 100 IAF aircraft over the Red Fort in Delhi. So, 15 August 1947, that is the day when we got our independence. And in honor of this day, he was asked to go for a flypast. Flypast means a drill performed by the different aircrafts and the pilots. So in this flypast, he was supposed to perform a drill with the help of 100 IAF, that is Indian Air Force aircraft. And this was to be performed over the New Fort, this was to be performed over the Red Fort in Delhi. So this is the picture of the drills that you can see, the flypast. After his promotion to the rank of wing commander, he attended the Royal Staff College at the UK. So I told you that now we are going to read about his promotions. So after being the squadron leader in 1944, again he was promoted and he came to the rank of wing commander. And then he was again sent to UK, United Kingdom, that is England, at the Royal Staff College. Immediately after Indian independence, he commanded Ambala in the rank of group captain. Then he also became the group captain for the Ambala cant, you can say. In 1949, he was promoted to the rank of air commodore and took over as air officer commanding, that is AOC, of an operational command which later came to be known as Western Air Command. So in 1949 again he got the promotion and he went into the rank of air commodore. Aur wahan pe unhone kaise join kiya tha? He joined as an air officer commanding, AOC. AOC ko fir baad mein ek naya naam diya gaya, that is Western Air Command. Singh had the distinction of having the longest tenure as AOC of an operational base. Initially from 1949 to 1952 and then again from 1957 to 1961. सो इट इज़ सेड हियर कि AOC कोई भी इतने लंबे समय तक नहीं था. सिर्फ सिंह ही ऐसे थे जिनको ये लॉन्गेस्ट टेनर मिला था. पहले वो AOC थे फ्रॉम 1949 टू 1952 और फिर वो दोबारा AOC बने फ्रॉम 1957 टू 1961. आफ्टर हिज प्रोमोशन टू द रैंक ऑफ एयर वाइस मार्शल, ही वॉज अपॉइंटेड एज द AOC इन सी ऑफ एन ऑपरेशनल कमांड. एंड उसके बाद उनको फिर से प्रमोशन मिला था, दिस टाइम टू द रैंक ऑफ एयर वाइस मार्शल. एंड हियर द पोस्ट दैट ही गॉट वॉज AOC इन सी. AOC इन सी मीन्स एयर ऑफिसर कमांडिंग इन चीफ. दिस इज अ चार्ट फ्रॉम वेयर यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द वेरियस प्रोमोशंस दैट ही हैड गॉट. तो यू कैन सी हियर, फर्स्ट ही वॉज द मेंबर ऑफ नंबर 1 RIAF, flying officer, squadron leader, फिर wing commander, group captain, air commodore, air officer commanding. बाकी का जो है वो next paragraph में है, air vice marshal, air officer commanding in chief, then deputy staff, deputy chief of air staff, vice chief of air staff, chief of air staff, air chief marshal. So in this way he kept on moving ahead. कहीं कोई रुकना नहीं था उनके लिए. Towards the end of the 1962 war, He was appointed as the deputy chief of the air staff and he became the vice chief of the air staff in 1963. So in 1962, again the war came to an end, that was against China. And here he was appointed as the deputy chief of the air staff. And in 1963, again he was promoted and he became the vice chief of the air staff. He was the overall commander of the Joint Air Training Exercise Siksha, held between IAF, RAF, that is Royal Air Force, and RAAF, Royal Australian Air Force. So there was a joint training session of three countries. ये एयर फोर्स के तीन कंट्री यहाँ पर मतलब थ्री कंट्रीज़ के जो एयर फोर्स थे दे हैड कम हियर एंड अ जॉइंट ट्रेनिंग सेशन वाज हेल्ड एंड ये जो सेशन था ही वाज द कमांडर ऑफ दैट सेशन सो इट वाज लाइक अ ग्रेट अचीवमेंट टू कमांड द ऑफिसर्स ऑफ अदर कंट्रीज इसमें जॉइन हुए थे इंडियन एयरफोर्स RAF मीन्स इंग्लैंड का एयरफोर्स And RAF, that is very clear, Royal Australian Air Force. So this was a great achievement for him. On August 1, 1964, in the rank of Air Marshal, the Marshal of the Air Force, Arjun Singh, took over reins of IAF at a time when it was still rebuilding itself and was gearing up to meet new challenges. So now he got to take over the control, took over reins. The meaning is already given there in the book, children, took over control. So on 1st August 1964, as a air marshal, he got the control over the Indian Air Force. And that time our Indian Air Force was just rebuilding itself. Khud ko aur strong bana raha tha hamara IAF. And we were getting ready. Gearing up means getting ready to meet the new challenges. And it was good ki 1964 mein humne apne Indian Air Force ko build up kiya tha because in 1965 we were going to have a war against Pakistan. So obviously this was a good good step that we took further. Singh was the first air chief to keep his flying currency till his CAS rank. Flying currency, you can see the meaning in the book, children. Up-to-date skills and experience of flying aircraft means CS rank and CS rank CS also the meaning is given chief of air staff तो वो CS बनने के बाद भी उन्होंने अपना flying experience बिल्कुल ख़त्म नहीं किया था he continued with the flying experience having flown over 60 different types of aircraft from pre-World War II era biplanes to more contemporary gnats and vampires he has also flown in transport aircraft till the Super Constellation. So he has a credit of flying many aircrafts. We read this line before also. उन्होंने वो aircraft भी उड़ाया था जो World War II से पहले भी बने थे और World War II में use हुए थे. और contemporary means present time, उनके समय का जो present time था उसमें gnats and vampires नाम के भी aircraft उन्होंने उड़ाए थे. सिर्फ उतना ही नहीं, उन्होंने transport aircraft तक भी fly किया था. That is Super Constellation. So these are the various types of aircrafts that he might have flown. In 1965, when Pakistan launched its Operation Grand Slam with an armored thrust targeted at the vital town of Akhnoor, Singh led IAF through the war with courage, determination, and professional skill. So in 1965, पाकिस्तान अटैक्ड ऑन इंडिया उस ऑपरेशन का नाम था ऑपरेशन ग्रैंड स्लैम एंड पाकिस्तान ने अटैक किया था अखनूर पे अखनूर इज़ अ सिटी इन कश्मीर सो द टारगेट वाज ऑन अखनूर एंड सिंह हैड टू गेट रेडी टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द पाकिस्तानी एयर फोर्स सो ही प्रिपेयर्ड हिज IAF वेरी स्ट्रांगली लाइक थ्री फीचर्स हैव बीन गिवन हियर विथ करेज डिटर्मिनेशन एंड प्रोफेशनल स्किल्स So all his strategies and whatever skills he had, he used that very time. He inspired IAF to victory despite the constraints imposed on the full-scale use of Air Force combat power. Constraints, the meaning is given restriction. Now the meaning of this sentence is like, you know, children. Unke upar restriction tha, wo pura IAF war mein use nahi kar sakte the. एक लिमिटेड पार्ट ऑफ IAF को ही यूज़ करने का परमिशन दिया था। तो यही सबसे बड़ी जीत थी उनकी कि विद सच अ स्मॉल पार्ट ऑफ IAF ही वॉज एबल टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द पाकिस्तानी एयरफोर्स। सिंह वॉज अवॉर्डेड पद्म विभूषण फॉर हिज एस्ट्यूट लीडरशिप ऑफ द एयरफोर्स ड्यूरिंग द वॉर। एस्ट्यूट द मीनिंग इज गिवन इन द बुक चिल्ड्रन, शार्प एंड इंटेलिजेंट। सो द वे ही परफॉर्म्ड इन द पाकिस्तान इन द वॉर अगेंस्ट पाकिस्तान, द लीडरशिप दैट ही शोड, फॉर दैट ही वॉज अवॉर्डेड विद पद्म विभूषण। सब्सिक्वेंटली इन रिकग्निशन ऑफ द एयरफोर्स कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ड्यूरिंग द वॉर, द रैंक ऑफ द CAS वॉज अपग्रेडेड and Arjun Singh became the first Air Chief Marshal of the Indian Air Force. And unka jo contribution tha, that was so remarkable, so important, that CAS jis rank pe wo the usko upgrade kar diya gaya, and thus he went on to become the first Air Chief Marshal of the Indian Air Force. He remained a flyer to the end of his tenure in IAF, visiting forward bases and units and flying with the squadrons. तो उनका जब तक tenure था, I mean जब तक वो एक officer थे IAF के लिए, till the end he did what he could. He used to visit the forward bases. Forward bases, the meaning is given there, children, a secured for forward operating military position. I mean there are many bases in India of Indian Air Force. So he used to keep on visiting those places जहाँ भी Indian Air Force का base था. Why he used to visit? Just to keep a check that everything is functioning properly or not. He retired in August 1969, thereupon accepting ambassadorship to Switzerland. He was Lieutenant Governor of Delhi from December 1989 to December 1990. So obviously after a remarkable contribution to Indian IF, that is Indian Air Force, he retired in August 1969, but उसके बाद उनको जॉब ऑफर आया एंड ही वॉज मेड द एम्बेसडर टू स्विट्ज़रलैंड. एम्बेसडर्स मीन्स हु रिप्रेजेंट देयर कंट्री. सो ही वेंट टू स्विट्ज़रलैंड एज अ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ इंडिया एंड देन ही ऑल्सो वेंट ऑन टू बिकम द लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर ऑफ दिल्ली फ्रॉम डिसम्बर 1989 टू डिसम्बर 1990. Having been a source of inspiration to all the personnel of armed forces, through the years, the government conferred the rank of the Marshal of the Air Force upon Arjun Singh in January 2002, making him the first and the only 5-star rank officer with Indian Air Force. So he was a source of inspiration to all the officers in Indian Air Force. Personnel means the employees, the officers of Indian Air Force. So seeing his contribution, he was given this marshal, he was given the rank of marshal of the Air Force on 26 January 2002. So he went on to become the first and the only 5-star rank officer with Indian Air Force.